Hello friends, I am ardhendude. You are watching Twentieth Century English Literature. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss how one act play made its entrance in English literature and how it concentrates both the denouement and climax within its short phase. The one-act play practically made its entrance in the 20th century and it concentrates both the denouement and climax within its short phase. Herman Old, one of the renowned critics, comments on one-act play as it may be neat, compact and rigid, but it may also be wayward, expansive and flexible, so long as it does not conflict with the fundamental principles of drama. It may venture it into 100 different directions and exploit almost as many themes as ingenuity and inventiveness of the author can suggest. Although in 20th century there is the preponderance of one-act play, its origin can be traced back to the 15th century among the morality, miracle and mystery plays. In old Sanskrit texts, there is also the shadow of one-act play, but among those plays, there is only the outward form, not the essence of the modern time. As a short story cannot be expanded into a novel, a one-act play cannot dare to be a full-fledged five-act play. The functioning of the one-act play is quite different from the five-act play. An one-act play does not have the time for elaborate speeches or meditative versification of the selective incidents within a short span of time are to be acted with the purpose of turning them into a dramatic climax. With the purpose of creating an impression and dramatic climax, the incidents are drawn are on a practical and particular setting involving a single character in it. A one-act play goes through three phases: exposition, growth and climax. Except all these machineries, a one-act play can be striking on its exposition, character, impression, setting or comicality. Norman McKenney's The Bishop's Candlesticks is a character-based play. Here Bishop appears quite a bold character, though through his generosity, humanity, patience and tolerance. Oliver Conway's Becky Sharp Callsworth is the little man, one of the beautiful one. David Scott's Daniels, The Queen and Mr. Shakespeare. Houseman's Under Fire, Morris Baring's The Rechazal and Monthon Roy's Buddhitporno are all character-based plays. Jacob's The Monkey's Paw has a supernatural atmosphere, whereas Gregory's The Rising of the Moon is artistically superb. Milner's The Bay Comes Home is a social critique comically expressed. James Sean's Riders to the Sea is one of the best one-act plays of the time and has all the requirements of such a play as brevity, compression and overall atmosphere of doom, a deep human tragedy. Sean is also able to combine with it a local color, presenting the real problems of the poor people of the Aran Islands. We can also mention one of the best one-act play in Bengali, Shubhojatra by Probir Mojumdar. Here the story reveals the author's sense of irony and deep insights. The future of one-act play is bright enough with the compulsion that the five-act play represents a full circle of life which demands more time and patience. But surely, to say A modern man has none of this. A one-act play represents a gleam of life in portion and particles which suits the modern theatre goers. The ingenuity and inventiveness of one-act playwrights have also enthroned it and made it a piece of excellence. So, with this message that you can have a taste of a drama within its one-act play and even a compact idea of dramatic climax and the presentation of it in a short span of time will surely lure you to further study and further watch one-act play. With that hope that you should watch and enjoy one-act play, I say goodbye for this class. Bye-bye. Like, share, comment, and obviously subscribe to my channel. Thank you.